Hi, I'm Chet Haas, an engineer on the Android team at Google. I work on graphics and animations, and today I wanted to talk a little bit about window animations. In another show that we did, we saw a little bit about view animations, which are the animation APIs that you can use for releases prior to 3.0. There's a more complete animation system starting with 3.0, but if you're doing window animations, you still want to use the animation resource files of the older API. So we'll see how to use those today to get different kinds of transitions between activities and sub-activities in your activity. So let's take a look at a demo. I call this demo window animations. And you'll see a few buttons and then a little bitmap down at the bottom. And each of the buttons enables a different type of window transition as it goes between the main activity and the sub-activity. So default animations, you just get whatever the system provides you, which is the scale fade, at least on the current platform. It's the scale fade activity, so we scale and fade in, we scale and fade out. That's the default. You can do translate animations, so you can provide a custom animation of any type that you specify using the view animation system. In this case, we're going to slide things in and out. So the translate animation slides in the new activity, slides out the old activity, and then when you back out, we get sort of the reverse thing, which is actually a separate animation, as we'll see in the code in a minute. Scale animations is a new capability that came online in Jelly Bean, where you can actually specify a subrectangle to launch the new activity from, and it'll scale up from that point. So it'll start out at the visuals that it's going to have when it's running in the full screen, and then it'll simply scale that up over time. So scale animation launches that window from the location that I gave it, which is relative to that button that we clicked on. Now you'll notice that although we scale into the activity, we still get some defaults or non-scaling animations when we back out of it. And this is a limitation of the current system where we can't scale back out of it. Instead, we can just use the prior way of, you know, translation or scale fade or whatever other kind of animation that you want. And then finally, we have the bitmap at the bottom, which is another variation of the scale animation where you can specify not only the subrectangle to scale from, but also the bitmap to start from. In this case, I took a screenshot of what the activity was going to look like, and I saved it at a smaller size, and we're simply going to scale up from that one into the larger one. So we can see that we get exactly the same kind of view scaling up into the larger activity. Now what that's hiding is that we're actually cross-fading from one representation to the other. So it starts out at the smaller bitmap, and then as it scales up, it also cross-fades to the full screen representation of the sub-activity. So that's the demo, but the more interesting part is the actual code. How does this stuff work? So we can take a look at this class I've defined called window animations. And in here we have the buttons that we saw on the screen, and then we have an image view that holds that bitmap. And as you click on each of the buttons, you get a different kind of effect depending on what we were trying to do with window animations. The default button just uses the system behavior. So when you click on that, it launches this subactivity. Let's take a quick look at subactivity. Not much going on there. It's just a subactivity. It only exists to provide something for us to look at when we transition to the subactivity. All right, so all it does is launch the subactivity, and then the system itself just takes care of doing the translation, the default scale fade transition that it normally has. The translate button, the second button down, did a custom animation where we slid the new activity in, slid the old activity out, and then on the way back out, we slid to the right instead, sort of a nice reversing behavior. It gives kind of an indication of the flow of the application in and out of the subactivity. So here, we launched a different subactivity, which we call animated subactivity, and I'll show you in a second why we were using not just the regular subactivity. And then we created a bundle, an activity options bundle, and said, okay, well, here's this custom animation that we're creating, and we're gonna load in a couple of resources here, so we can take a look at those in our resources folder. In the anim directory, we have a slide in left resource, which is a translate animation that's going to slide in and have the duration capabilities specified in it. So we're going to start at a from X delta. So we're basically going to start off the screen 100% of the width of my parent. And then we're going to slide into an X delta of 0. So we're going to start out there and then slide in over a duration of 500 milliseconds. Go back, we can take a look at the other animation we're specifying. So that was for the new activity coming in. And then slide out left was for the activity going out. Slide out left, we can see here, and then this one starts from an x delta of 0, so basically where that activity is now, and it's going to slide out to half the width of the parent out, over 500 milliseconds. So it would be sort of a parallax effect. They're actually going at a different rate. It's not just moving together in lockstep, but instead one is moving in faster than the other is going out. Kind of a nice effect there. Now, the reason we had an animated subactivity there is because the transitions that we specify here for the window animations only control what happens when we go into the subactivity. But what if we actually want to have a custom transition coming back out of that activity as well? Well, for that, we need a little bit of code in the subactivity. So instead of using the normal subactivity with no behavior specified in it, we have this animated subactivity. And here we override the finish method, call super, and then override pending transition. Then we specify different transitions, which we don't need to go in and look at the code. It's fairly straightforward. Basically, we're sliding the subactivity out to the right and then sliding the main activity in to the right as well, sort of the reverse from the transition that we did to begin with. Okay, so now we can go back and look at the original code and see the more interesting stuff, what's going on with those thumbnail scaling animations instead. Again, we use activity options. This is the one where we scaled up from the button itself, and we basically give it the rectangle that it's going to scale from. But for the content that it's actually going to scale on the screen, it uses the content of the full screen activity itself. So we don't need to specify anything else there. We just say, where do you start from and how large are you? And then it takes care of all the rest of scaling that thing in over time. And finally, on the last one, when we're actually scaling in from a thumbnail, we not only give it the location that it's going to scale from, but we also give it the bitmap that it's going to use. So it's going to start with that representation and then scale up and fade into crossfade into the full screen activity that you're going into. So here we create this bitmap. We're actually just loading a bitmap. This is the screenshot that I took earlier and saved as a drawable. And then we create some activity options with the appropriate parameters and start the activity. And then the window animation just uses that bundle to run the appropriate animation. So these are window animations. They're useful for giving a custom look to your application, your activities. It's important to point out that you can do this for sub-activities. It's a little trickier to do it for main activities, and the general advice is don't. It's kind of nice for the users to have a consistent experience across the device as they're using the main UI, and part of that is getting consistent transition behaviors as they launch activities. Now, once they're in your activity, that's a custom experience. That's totally understandable how you might want to customize that according to what your application needs to do. But as far as going between activities or just launching it from the launcher screen, it's kind of nice to let the default system behavior still stay intact and use the custom window animations for the activity transitions actually within your activities. Thanks for tuning in.